James Cook University, being situated in the tropics, has got a very strong focus on tropical research. So my group focuses on marine habitat research and particularly focusing on seagrass and seagrass ecology. We've spent a lot of time developing partnerships with industry. So our approach has been working with industries that are in the marine environment and trying to come up with solutions for them so that they can continue what they do in a way that minimises or reduces any impacts to the marine environment. We've got a couple of programs that we run at the centre, and one of them is basically looking at seagrasses in all of Queensland's commercial ports that have seagrass. That started off with the NQBP port. Back in 1994, North Queensland Bulk Ports approached us to look at seagrasses in one of the ports where they were going to be doing some work. And that one project where we actually found seagrass and were able to map it, and they were able to use that to plan the development of the port so that it wasn't going to impact on the seagrass there, spawned a statewide program looking at seagrasses and monitoring and protecting them in pretty much all of Queensland's commercial ports. And currently all of the NQBP ports are part of that program. It's probably one of the biggest seagrass research programs in Australia. Well, we've learnt a lot actually, and you know, some of the work that stemmed directly from the monitoring we're doing in the ports has really led to some pretty big advances in our knowledge of how seagrass works and how it grows. Seagrasses are a really critical coastal marine habitat. They're plants. Unlike algae, they're actually quite complex. They're flowering plants, roots and rhizomes, they're structurally a lot more complex. So because of that, they perform some really important roles. They're a key habitat for commercial fishery species. Tiger prawn juveniles live in them. They're really productive, so they grow really quickly, and the tropical ones, they turn over really rapidly. I mean, being plants, they need nutrients to grow, so they can act as a bit of a filter of the water coming out from the coast out to the reef. It's really important to monitor seagrass because it's not a constant, it doesn't just stay the same and it comes and goes. There's a lot of seasonality, unlike a lot of plants, and quite extreme in some seagrasses as well. Some of those seagrasses in ports are annual, they're only there for 3 months of the year and got to come back from seed. So if you want to make sure that you've got healthy seagrass in the port environment or any environment, you really need to get a good handle on how it changes naturally and put that into perspective when there's potential impacts around. One of the keys for the monitoring that we're doing specifically in the ports is that the ports have used seagrasses. They're kind of like the canary in the coal mine because they respond to all elements of water quality. You know, if you affect light, you affect nutrients, or if there's pesticides, herbicides, you know, all of these things will actually impact on the way seagrasses grow. So by looking at seagrasses each year in the port and just seeing that they're healthy, it's a really good indicator that you've got a healthy marine environment overall. Then beyond that, it's for planning purposes. So obviously ports have got activities going on. There's often required expansion, there's maintenance dredging, there's new facilities that go on. So first off, we go in and do a baseline survey. We map everything that's there. And depending on where the seagrass is, you know, intertidally, we'll do it with helicopters, the shallow areas with cameras or divers, depending on how many crocodiles are around. And then the deeper areas, we actually have a camera system that's towed behind a boat with a live feed back to the boat, and we map it that way. We've been working with the environment team at the port for, as I say, for 20 years, and we work very closely with them, particularly when it comes to issues with seagrasses. And NQBP have been very proactive in seeking out information. So a lot of the stuff that we know about seagrasses is because they've got the program in place, and it's strategic in the sense that it's there regardless of whether there's going to be a dredging operation or not. The monitoring happens, so we've got good information. A partnership approach with industry can definitely work, and it certainly has for us in this arena. And if you can work with industries to highlight the problems and come up with solutions collaboratively, then that can be a good result all around. So.